everyone, this is Owen with ShiftClickLearn. Today I'm excited to show you guys how I drew a skunk in Inkscape. So let's hop right into it. Alrighty, so this is the cute skunk that I am going to be drawing. As you can see, he kind of had a little bit of an accident and is stinking up the place. Yeah, he really needed to go. So let's start drawing this. First of all, we're going to need to hold control and draw a circle. And the reason we're holding control is so that it's a perfect circle. Then we're going to change this color to a nice dark gray color. Next, what we are going to do is go to path and do object to path. Double click this so we can adjust the nodes. And as you can see here, these handles go out pretty far. What I want to do is hold control and pull them in towards the middle. And as you can see, the control keeps it straight. And then once we pull it in, as you can see, it kind of gives it that little head shape. Next, what I want to do is go ahead and draw kind of a hair shape. It's going to curve up, then have a bunch of curves down. And this will just make it look like it has some droopy hair coming down, maybe some really long, big ones. But yeah, this is just some details. I want to make this a nice gray color like so and adjust it as necessary. Next, what I want to do is hold Control D on this and actually change this color to a slightly brighter version of this hair. And then I want to pull this up a teeny bit. I want to move it to the side and then pull it up and then move it back. I'll also rotate it a bit. Next, what I'll do is add in some highlights. So right here would be a little bit shiny. So I'll go ahead and add a circle there. Right here would have a little bit of shine to it. Right here would definitely, because it's quite a big spot here. Probably right here and definitely right here. Next, I'm going to go ahead and select all of these and make this fill a white color. And as you can see now, this looks like it's detailed. Another thing that you can do is go in here to the nodes of the bottom layer and actually change up the shape a bit to make it look like it's another layer and it's not exactly the same. And this will just add a little bit of detail. Next thing I'll do is click on the head and hold Control D and size this down quite a bit and change the color to a pink nose color. I do want to change the shape up a bit because it's the exact same shape as the head and that's kind of weird. So I want to hold Control and just move this down to where it's like that. And as you can see, this creates more of a nose look. Next, I want to add the eyes. So I'm going to hold Control and draw a black circle like so, and it's just going to be pure black like I already said. I'm going to move this around. Next, what I'll do is hold Control D and change the duplicated circle to a blue color. And what I'll do is hold Control and size this up a teeny bit. Next, I'll do page down. As you can see, he has a little blue rim around his eyes and it looks super duper cute. And you can always adjust this to how much blue you want in there. I just want a teeny bit in there. So I'll go ahead and draw a white circle up above like so. Shift click all of this and group it up like that. I'll go ahead and duplicate this, flip this duplicated one horizontally, and ungroup it to where the light source still comes from the top. Then I'll go ahead and regroup this. Now that we have that out of the way, I want to draw some eyebrows. So I'm gonna go ahead and make a nice curved shape like so. One end is decently pointy and one end kind of just curves up. This is just going to be a darker version of the skin tone, or it would be more like a fur tone, but I'll move this up, hold Control D, flip this horizontally for the other side. And this is going to be curved towards the right to make it look like he's kind of like, oops, I didn't mean to do that. Another thing I'll do is go ahead and draw the ears. So I want to draw one big circle like so and make it the same exact color as the main body here, or head, I guess. And then I want to click on the circle, duplicate it, and size it up to the left and change this color to a darker version of that ear like so, and then do that. So now we have a nice ear. We can go ahead and group that and then do page down. And as you can see, this looks good. We can rotate it and all that nice stuff. So I want to kind of make this look like he's looking to the left slightly. So I want to select all the facial features and move it to the left. Maybe the nose rotated to the left just to make it look like he's looking. And because he's rotated to the left, the right ear would be showing more. I want to duplicate this ear, flip it horizontally, and make it slightly less visible on the left side, and also size it down a teeny bit just to make it look like there's depth. But as you can see here, this makes it look like he's looking to the left. For this next bit, I want to draw the tail, but this is pretty challenging, so I'm going to duplicate the other tail and just use it as a reference piece here so that way I can look at it right away. But the general shape is you want to go ahead and draw a nice curve going up. Then this part doesn't really matter. Then it's going to go up again. And it's kind of going to have a curve, a dip in the middle, and then another curve up like a little hill. And then we're going to come down and back into the body. This is going to be the first chunk of the tail. And the reason we did this curve is to make it look like it goes down. This fill is going to be the same color as the body, and we're not going to have a stroke on that. We're going to go ahead and do page down. Once you're happy with the general shape, what I want to do is go ahead and draw this little end of the tail that comes down. So kind of make this connect back to the first node, then curve down, have two little tippy thingies on the end, and then come back up. Now I want to make this a slightly darker version of this. That's why it's separate, is so we can make it a slightly different color. Then I want to actually go through here, start at the beginning, and make a shape showing where it would be separated. Kind of like that. And as you can see, this looks a ton better than without a tail, just because obviously skunks have tails. Another big thing to think about is adding some stripes, because this is a skunk. So I want to go ahead and dial down this hump on the left side because it's a teeny bit big. Then I want to go ahead and draw a stripe coming from the first hump, going down, curving to give it some 3D shape, coming behind the hair back up to the top. And then you want to kind of match the general shape of this hump, make this a white color, and then do the same exact thing you did before on the left side, or the right side if you did the other one first. And there you go. As you can see, once we do page down, this actually looks a lot like a skunk, and it looks nice. Another thing you can do is add a body. So I want to draw a circle and somewhat like that, make this a darker version of the body, then do page down to the back. I want to go path object to path, that way we can adjust these nodes a little bit, maybe make these top nodes a little bit out some so it makes it look more like a body, and maybe make these come out a teeny bit. Yeah, just making it look like a body in general. And once you're happy with that, we need to add the paws. This is a bit tricky to get, but you know, it just takes a little bit. So what I want to do is draw a first little toe here, come out and do another little toe like so, come out and do another little toe like this, and then come in to make the final node. Then this is going to be the exact same color, and what I want to do is come in here and smooth all of this out and get this to look like a nice paw. And this part right here does not need to have space in between. It can just be solid like this. That's actually what I want it to be, as you can see, and it looks better anyway. Duplicate it and flip it horizontally and move it to the right because he's looking to the left. So that just adds a little bit of detail to it because he would be leaning a little bit. Now what we want to do is add a small stripe to his body. And to do this, we're going to click on the visor tool here and just come down and draw a little shape on his belly, then come up kind of like a potion almost shape, and then it's going to be a darker than white color. The final thing I want to add is the leg on the sides. Go ahead and click on this paw, duplicate it, and then click on the body and also duplicate it, move it up to the right and the top, and then make it a darker color, then make the paw the same color as the little body here. And now we can go ahead and size this around and all that stuff, but boom, we have a wonderful skunk here. Could stop here because we're done with all these skunk parts, but I do want to add a little bit of cartoonish aspect to it, make him kind of explode in green stench. So I'll go ahead and draw a circle, make this that neon green, and make it slightly transparent, and I believe it's actually 56. Oh wow, I did it perfectly, 56. Then I'll duplicate this a bunch of times and kind of just make a rough shape to make it look like it's random, then group this together and move this to the back. Next, what I'll do is duplicate this and flip this horizontally, rotate it, move it around, duplicate it more times, flip it vertically now, and just do that a bunch of times and try to get it to look a little bit natural to make it look like he exploded in fart juice. And but I want some of it to be in front. As you can see, this part is in front of his ear. Then I want some of it to be in back, and I want this one to actually be in front of his body, and that one to be in behind the ear, and just that's really just gives it some depth. Then to take this to the next level, I want to add some exclamation points that kind of have a comic booky style to it. So I'll go ahead and click on the little T down here, or the A, I guess, and draw an exclamation point. Not draw, type the exclamation point, size this up, and make this a dark red down here, as you can see. And what I'll go ahead and do is draw a spiky shape surrounding this exclamation point, which kind of just makes it look like a comic book, and I really like the look of it for this drawing. And once you're done, you're going to want to make this fill a yellow color like so and do page down. And to finalize it, duplicate this and change it to a bright red, size it up a little bit, and then move it back over and do page down. So it kind of makes it look like a cartoon. Group this and size this until you like it. So I'm going to put one over here, one slightly rotated to the left and smaller, maybe behind this little gas cloud here, another one that's even more rotated to the right and very small in the background. But yeah, this one looks very good. So now it looks like it's like, oh no, and everyone's yelling, and it's like, oh, we're all gonna die because it stinks so bad. Now we are actually done. So thank you all so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video and maybe even learned something. If you did, then make sure to smash that like button and consider subscribing. Thank you all so much for over 50 subscribers. That's just awesome. But yeah, thanks for watching. Anyways, this has been Owen, and I'm out. So go ahead and click on this little thing here and duplicate it and then move it. What is this? Oh yeah, I'll click on this paw like your grandpa. Paw. Okay, that's stupid. And make this to add more cartoonishizations to it. How would you say that?